Hey guys, Firmware 2.0 is out and it has plenty of new amazing features that I can't wait to show you. So let's have a look.
So Firmware 2.0 came with two major new features. And the first one is called MIDI Forwarding, which basically before Firmware 2.0, a device like this one, which only has one MIDI input, as you can see, and no USB input, if you wanted to send the clock to it from the Midronome and at the same time send a MIDI note from a DAW, for example, then you would need to merge the two together. And now the Midronome does that for you. So how does that look like? Well, in live, for example, in the preferences, we have MIDI out 1 and 2, which match the MIDI out 1 and 2 here. And basically any MIDI data that you send to these interfaces gets forwarded and merged with the clock. So here, for example, I'm sending this to MIDI out 2 on channel 10. And when I press play, it makes this play. And that's notes sent from this, as you can see. And the second new feature of the Firmware 2.0, it's about synchronization, external synchronization of the Midronome. So before in the setup in IMP, we only had the option sync. And now after pad and pad dot dot dot, which are the drum pads options, we have 24p and 24p dot dot dot. And basically, I've renamed a little bit all these options. So if we have a look at the website and we go on the Midronome support, and by the way, I highly recommend you have a look at how to sync with DAWs if that's what you want to do, because this manual has been updated. But looking at the Midronome user guide, we can scroll down to external sync. So external sync is now the name for all the synchronization options. And the sync option is now called Midrosync because it's very specific to Midronome. So that's the way it was previously done with DAWs. And it's still the way you can sync two Midronomes together. And the new options are just called 24PPQ. And basically these options, in this mode, the device will sync to anything that sends 24PPQ pulses. And just so you know, 24PPQ, there's like 64th notes triplets. And what does send 24PPQ pulses? Well, the new Midronome plugin that you can see right here. So I've made an entire video about how to use the plugin, so I'm not going to show that here. But shortly said, you just put it on a track, you send the track to an external output, in this case, DAW 3, and then you send that external output to the input of the Midronome. So let's choose 24P in this case, and when we press play in the DAW, we can see it takes one bar to sync and then it's in sync with the metronome. And then we can start a drum machine, for example, and everything is in time. And if we change the tempo, it goes along with it. And that's the plugin working, sending different time pulses. What the plugin also does, which is really practical, is sending MIDI data. So this is another track that takes the MIDI data from the plugin and sends it to Midronome commands on channel 12. It has to be channel 12. And basically, this will set the tempo via MIDI when it's not playing. And the other mode, the 24p dot dot dot, it's basically a mode where the device is not running as a master clock anymore. So in this mode, you can see that when the DAW is not playing, this is still running. You can use it, you can start your machine. But if I change this to 24p dot dot dot, the master mode is just not running. So basically the device is off until it receives something from the DAW. But then there is no more of that one bar delay. Basically the device is ready and starts right away, as you can see. And then it still syncs. So let's speak about the other features that Firmware 2.0 came with. So if we go on the forum in potential future release, we have the complete list. And so these are the two major features we just spoke about. There's three minor features that were added. So the first one is autoplay mode. And that's actually a really cool thing. Is if you're in your DAW, and basically what you want to do is when you press play, you want to start your machine at the same time. So what you normally would is press play and then press the play button and then it starts. And when you press stop in the DAW, you need to press stop on the Midronome as well. But now you can just go in the setup, find the auto play option and just set that to on. And now whenever it starts synchronization with the DAW, it starts automatically. And then when you press stop, it stops automatically. And the next two features are send MIDI notes off. So whenever the device sends stop, it will send MIDI notes off to MIDI stop. So it's just like a small thing to make sure that you don't have any hanging notes somewhere. And the last one is about the MIDI CC commands. So whatever you can send on the USB cable. And you can see in the user guide, in USB communication, we have Midronome commands. So before you could already change tempo and time signature, this was added in firmware 1.1. And now we have this one. So if you send on CC 104 and 105, you will actually change the settings, which are on analog 1. So this, the speed of the clock on the analog plug. So this way you can automate it in your flow. And this is the list of the small issues that were solved. I'll let you have a look at it on the forum if you want. And then on top of this, there has been quite a few internal improvements. The first thing was about the MIDI start messages. So basically before, the start messages would be sent just before a clock, and that could create some problems on some devices as they will ignore maybe the first clock that was sent. And now to make sure that it's more either not just after a clock, not just before either, it's just right in the middle. So it's sure that it's taken into account correctly. The second one is about how external sync will not show error. So I remember a lot of you, I'm sure, have experienced this. When you set your input to external sync, so which before was only SYN, but now is also 24p and 24p dot dot dot. Any of these, basically, if the sync signal that was sent here on this cable was wrong, then the device would show error. So the difference now is the device would do everything that it can to maintain the sync, even if it means skipping pulses. So if pulses come too fast, for example, it would just ignore them and sync to whatever it can. Then there was the full lock mode that was removed. I don't think anybody has ever used this. If you have, please let me know. And then the play button pressing time to send resync. That was a great suggestion from someone in the forum, actually. So basically, say you want to start your machine here, and for some reason it gets out of sync. This could be if you press play. Now you can hear it's not in time with the click. And you just have to hold this down to do a resync on the next bar. And now they're in sync. And before you had to hold this down for an entire second, well now it's just 300 milliseconds. And the last thing is the module interface. What is the module interface?
And that's an excellent question, Mr. Simon from the video. But that will be for next time. In the meantime, you guys have a great day. Thank you for watching and see you next time. Bye.